In the previous video, you saw how to import media into Smoke, as well as conform timelines from other non-linear editors. Now that you have the clips in the media library, let's start sorting and organizing the media. Just a quick note, everyone has their own way of organizing their sources, and I'm sure you do too. All I'm going to do is show you the tools and you can organize the media that best suits your editorial workflow. So it doesn't really matter if you're in the media hub or in the timeline view. At any point, you can rearrange your media as you see fit. At the top of the media library is the root level. You can add folders at the root level simply by right-clicking on the media library title and choosing New Folder from the pop-up menu. Notice that you cannot click in the empty space below this folder. This is a different shade of gray. You can give a folder a name and press Enter to confirm. Source clips can be selected individually or in a group. Selection works just like the Mac OS Finder. Select one clip, and then shift-click another clip to select a range. You can also hold down the command to select non-contiguous clips. With the clips selected, you can drag and drop the clips into the folders. At any point, you can click on a folder or clip and rename them. You can also create folders within folders to further manage your editorial workflow. Just so that you're aware, the right-click menu of the cursor contains all the common commands such as cut, copy, paste, duplicate, and delete. Please note that you are not actually deleting your source footage when you delete clips out of the media library. This is something you would do through the Media Hub file browser or the Mac OS Finder. Now, with all this organization going on in the folders, Autodesk Smoke also has a search tool located at the bottom of the media library window. Simply type in a keyword and Smoke will display a list of search results at the bottom of the media library list. This will be expanded to advanced searches in upcoming builds of the pre-release trial. Incidentally, the Media Hub also has a similar search facility. One important function to be aware of is the connection between the media library and the source viewer. When you select a source clip, it is automatically loaded into the source viewer. In the media library, the green triangle icon next to the source clip indicates that this source is the currently loaded source in the source viewer. There is no need to double-click on a source clip to load it into the source viewer. Simply select it. Now, when a clip is selected in the media library and loaded into the source viewer, you can obviously scrub and play the clip. One function I want to point out is subclipping. If you have a source clip that you imported into Smoke, which is extremely long, you can mark up the clip in the source viewer by clicking the in and out points below the source viewer. Clicking on the clip menu in the top menu bar, you can choose subclip, and a subclip will be created in the menu library underneath the original source clip. So you can organize your media and prepare your clips for the edit. In the next video, we will look at the source viewer in greater detail.